By now, you've probably heard of two types of tests for SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19. The first test is called a PCR test, or a polymerase chain reaction test. It is highly sensitive and almost 100% accurate in detecting people who have been infected with the virus. This test picks up viral RNA and is able to detect a minuscule amount in people who have been infected with COVID-19. Recently, the use of these tests has been restricted to people who are in high-risk categories. The second test is called a rapid antigen test. You might be more familiar with these tests and have some at home or at work. These tests detect viral proteins or antigens found on the surface of the virus. They are extremely specific and very fast. You can get results in 15 minutes. However, they're not highly sensitive. If you get a negative result, you might need to test several times before you get a positive result. So where PCR tests can detect a single molecule of RNA per microliter, rapid antigen tests need thousands or even tens of thousands of viral particles to show a positive result. So what does this mean for you? Rapid antigen tests will detect COVID-19 in people that have a high viral count and are probably more contagious. But a negative test doesn't mean that you aren't infected. It could mean that you just haven't made enough viral particles yet. Trust a positive test, but be skeptical of a negative test. It's a good idea to use your rapid antigen test strategically. Test a few days after a known exposure or after being in a high-risk situation. Another name for a rapid antigen test is a lateral flow test. It's like a pregnancy test, and it comprises of two steps. Step one, make all the viral proteins a color. Step two, collect all of the proteins in one place so we can see how much of them there are. The test strip uses the power of absorption or capillary action, like in a paper towel, to pull the liquid up the test strip. When the nose swab liquid hits the test strip, it will migrate up the test strip, much like water being absorbed in a paper towel. The nose swab liquid first encounters the coloring layer, which contains antibodies that connect to the viral protein, kind of like a lock and key. But on the other end of the antibodies, we have a coloring agent, gold for red or latex for blue, and this will color our proteins. The next line that we will encounter is the test line. This also has antibodies, but they're stuck in place and they will trap the colored viral particles. This is the line that will tell you if you're positive or not. A deeper color means that you have more viral particles. A fainter color on this line means you have less viral particles. If you have no line, maybe you don't have the virus, or maybe you haven't made enough viruses yet. The last part of the test is called the control line. There are other color molecules that are found in the color layer that travel up with the test liquid. The control line ensures that your test had worked and the liquid has moved up your test strip. If you don't see a color in the control line, your test probably didn't work and you should try again. Hopefully this will help you understand how rapid antigen tests work and what to expect when testing yourself and your family. It's good to know that if you can't test and have symptoms, assume that you have COVID-19, and please isolate for the recommended amount of time. Thanks so much and stay safe.